from Los Angeles. This is Montserrat Radio.
Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Anybody grateful tonight? Let me hear you. Put your hands together.
in this particular season. This has been a season of unusual warfare, and you've seen a lot of different people sown into the Narland. And sometimes people are sown into the Narland, and I've been calling it the Nar Nation, because some people have been put in here for lack of a better word, to try your faith. We know it's done. We have prayed it's done. We believe that the Spirit have shown us it's done. There have been many prophecies. Okay, great, he's on. There have been many prophecies going forth. But I want to tell you, God will share his glory with no man. Hear me when I say that. God will share his glory with no man. No man can stand in the presence of the Lord save the Holy Spirit and the blood of Jesus be with him. So you know he's not going to share his glory with no man. No man, this is what Abraham said, Abram. No man made me rich but God. Hallelujah. You want to give God optimum glory? You want to give God optimum praise? Will you exchange? Wesley, how have you been so blessed? And I want you to tell them, no man made me wealthy but God. But God. No. No senator, no congressman, no guru, no cartoon character, only God. The Bible says it. Coming from the Father of lights. If this is a good and perfect gift, it has come from you. Do you think the enemy wants you wealthy? Do you really think the devil, the enemy, Satan, Lucifer, wants you wealthy? No, he wants you to continue broke. He wants you busted. He wants you disgusted. He wants you to not know whether you're coming up or going down. He wants your faith low. That's why some have been sown into the null and saying, oh, it ain't going to happen. Oh, that devil is a liar. It has already happened. Hallelujah. It has already happened in faith. God has already done it. You listen. Don't, and I made a post earlier this week, guy. Don't get thrown off with things. Don't get thrown off with things. People say little silly stuff. Don't get thrown off with that. If you are born again, blood-bought believer, you know in your spirit things are done. Now, does it have to roll out? Yes, but remember this. All things work together like a puzzle. Work together for the good of them that love the Lord, the called according to his purpose. All things work together. Every delay works for our good. Because it has not been a denial. Every delay, anything they do, anything any cabal member do, anything any white hat member do, anything anybody does, as far as the Christian is concerned, works together for our good. Love the Lord, and we are called according to his purpose. What's his purpose? We are going to honor him with these funds. We are going to honor him with the tithe. We are going to honor him with the offering. We are going to build churches around the world. Hallelujah. We're going to fund missions. We are going to feed the hungry, clothe the naked. That's what we're going to do. Amen. And when people ask us, we're going to give them in the name of the Lord. Amen. A cup of cold water. If you give a person a cup of cold water in the name of the Lord, you shall be blessed. So when you're paying off people's homes, when you're paying off people's cars, when you see an old mother that you need, you say, Mother, I see you on the bus stop. You've been walking for years. I want to take you and buy you something. give praise and glory to God. You can only spend so much on yourself. How many Louis Vuitton purses you gonna buy?
And I keep saying this, and I'm a keep on saying it until we exchange, but you have been handpicked and been set in this opportunity to be a blessing to the world. And it's nobody's goal but God's. And He is choosing to give it to you. You are less than 1%. The world don't know about this. They don't. They have no idea. So God handpicked you. It must have been something about your heart that He saw. You could be learning about this 2 years from now. You could be exposed to this 10 years from now and be reading about it and knew nothing about it and still be slaving and walking, just trying to make it over. But God said, no, I see something in my son, I see something in my daughter, and I'm going to mine that treasure. And not only am I going to mine that treasure, I am going to set them in a place of prosperity so they can bless not only my kingdom, but they can bless the world. That's why you're here, ladies and gentlemen. That's why you're here. It's like pumping a well. Imagine I'm standing in front of you and I'm pumping a water well. I'm trying to get water to a village. I'm trying to get water to a nation. And I'm pumping the well up and down, up and down. And I'm giving it all I got. And I'm almost there. I'm pumping the well. And I'm almost there. And I hear the water gushing. And I hear the water flowing. Now we got a well. Now we got water running through a well. Now we got water running through a nation. Now we got water running through a village. The water's running. Clean water. Pure water. Water they can drink with. Water they can cook with. And we're still pumping. And now we can stop pumping because the water is running. Now, let me ask you this. In the process of you pumping the water, you are going to get wet. What am I saying to you? In the process of you blessing others, God is going to bless you. In the process of you blessing others, you yourself will be blessed. We pray the wrong things as Christians. I never pray, Lord, bless me, no, Lord, make me a blessing. Make my name great and make me a blessing. Why? Because I understand when He blesses me to be a blessing, I like to get wet. I can't give you water and don't get wet. I can't pour water for you and not have a little bit in my glass. Hallelujah. When my cup runs over, that means I have enough to give. So remember that. And let me tell you another thing. Don't let these people get you off. This is a Holy Ghost takeover. This is a Holy Ghost maneuver. God has been maneuvering some things to get us in the position, the proper position to be blessed. Don't worry about people. Listen, don't worry about what people say. It ain't going to happen. The devil is a lie. They're trying to play with your mind. It is going to happen. It has happened. It's got to happen. And God is setting us up to receive it when it does. Don't worry about that. You hear different things. You're tossed to and fro. Don't be like the man that's tossed to and fro. The Bible says that if any man lacketh wisdom, thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord, thank you. I hear him loud and clear. This is what I want you to start doing. And Denarland, those of you that's on this prayer call, I can talk. I wish I could talk to them. This esoteric beliefs. God is not in that. He is not in that. He is not in that. There is no other name under heaven that men may be saved. Save the name of Jesus Christ. If you don't come to me talking about Jesus, I'm going to dismiss you. Don't come to me talking about all these other esoteric forces. I'll bind them and I'll bind you. For I give no praise, no glory, but to God and God alone. Jehovah God Himself, His Son Jesus Christ, and the power of His Spirit. That's all I want to hear about. I don't want to hear about none of the rest of that foolishness, because that's all it is. And it's confusing you. And God is not pleased. I said, God is not pleased. the blood of Christ was shed for you, that he would save you, that he would sanctify you, that he would fill you with the Holy Spirit, and that he would deliver you. That's the only thing you need to know about. Stop reading all this crazy stuff, all this crazy foolishness. Stop reading all that stuff. Stop reading it. Read your intel, and then put your mind back on the Christ man, Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, I had to say that. But here, this is what the Lord is saying. If any man lacketh wisdom, when you're reading intel, thank you, Lord, when you're reading intel, I don't care who it's from. I care not who it's from. Whether it's from Brother Benny, whether it's from Tony, Ray, who's some other people? Mountain Goat, who else? Tank, Becky Utah, who is the new one that's come on around here, the cartoon character, Kim Possible, whether it's her, whether it's Frank 26, whether it's Brother John Negro, I don't care who it is, when you're reading intel, this is what I want you to do. Say, Spirit of the living God, give me the spirit of wisdom to be able to decipher what is real and what is false. I'm telling you guys, it'll save you heartache and save you from being all over the place. You, Spirit of the living God, as I read this intel, give me wisdom on what to take and what to leave. The old folks say, eat the meat, throw away the bone. Can't eat bones. Eat the meat, throw away the bones. And if you do that, the Bible says, if you acknowledge him, the Bible says this, trust in the Lord. Check me out. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not into your own understanding. In all thy ways. In all thy ways. Not just in prayer, but in all thy ways. So when you're reading intel, in all thy ways, when you're listening to calls, in all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he will, not Frank 26, not Tony and Ray, not Brother Benny, not Becky, not Tank, not the rest of these guys, God will direct your path. That's why the Lord sent me into Denar Land, because I've got to tell you stuff like this, because he wants your mind on him. At the end of the day, he wants your mind on him, and he's going to bring this thing to pass. The manifestation is shortly to appear before you, but in the meantime, keep your mind on him. Keep your mind on him. Why? Because he said, if any man lacketh wisdom, let him ask of the freely given God, who giveth freely and upbraideth not. That means he don't hold back. He's not stingy with his wisdom. But check this out. Let that man ask in faith, nothing wavering, because he'll be like a man that's tossed to and fro on the sea, double-minded, unstable in all his ways. Let not that man think he's going to receive anything from the Lord. You can't be double-minded in God. If it's done, it's done. If it's finished, it's finished. If you have prayed and God told you that the only thing we're waiting on is the manifestation, that's the only thing you're waiting on is the manifestation. But in the meantime, pray. And let me tell you something else, too. In the meantime, I'm going to pray this tonight. In the meantime, while we are waiting on the manifestation, I am going to pray that God meet your needs. Amen. So you're not living hand to mouth. Amen. Hand to mouth. You can barely make it. Yes, is the RV going to happen? Yes, is the GCR going to happen? Yes, is the Lord going to come through? Yes, but in the meantime, I am going to pray that God supernaturally sustain us until we get our hands on the blessing, which shall be soon. Let me read you a passage of scripture that the Lord gave me right before the start of the call, and then we're going to have prayer. But let me give you this passage of scripture. If you have your Bibles, this is what I want you to look at all week. Luke 11, Matthew, Mark, Luke 11. And I am going to start at verse 5, Luke 11 and 5. And I want you to meditate on this scripture all week long. All week long. That means today, well, actually tonight, tomorrow, for the rest of the week, I want you to meditate on this scripture here. Luke 11, 5. Check this out. And he said unto them, which of you shall have a friend, and shall go unto him at midnight, and say unto him, friend, lend me 3 loaves, for a friend of mine is in his journey, is come to me, and I have nothing to set before him. And he from within shall answer and say, trouble me not, the door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed, I cannot rise and give thee. I say unto you, though he will not rise and give him, because he is his friend, yet because of his importunity, he will rise and give him as many as he needeth. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and the door shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. If a son shall ask bread of any of you that is a father, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent? Or if he shall ask for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion? If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask him? Let me tell you something. If you've been praying for this army, you've been fasting for this army, you have been fasting that God take you from poverty to prosperity, that is like you asking for a piece of bread. That is like you asking for a fish. Trust me, God is not going to give you a serpent, and he is not going to give you a stone. That's a cool father. That's not who we serve. I am telling you, this thing is done. And the scripture above it basically just talks about the man did not get out the bed because the other man was a friend. The man got out the bed because of his importunity. What does that mean? That means his demanding, his craving, his begging, his asking. That's why the man got out and gave him the loaves. Some of you have been begging for this. Some of you have been craving for this. Some of you have been asking for this for years. I am telling you, God heard your prayer. He heard your prayer. There were some things that needed to take place, and there were some things and probably some people that did not need to be where they were, whether it was governmental, presidents, or whoever it was. God did this thing, I am telling you. I am telling you. God did this thing, and it's not but by grace alone. The Bible says, it talks about it's not by power, but as by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. That's the only way this thing is done, my good people. That's it. The devil don't want you wealthy. These cabal, these politicians don't want us to have nothing. They want us to depend on them and this governmental system. But God says, not my people. God, hallelujah. 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 God says, not my people. And please understand, it's not their gold anyway. It's not their silver anyway. It's not their currency anyway. They may have printed currency. They may have mined the gold, but it all came from God anyway. You can't even print a printing. You can't even build a printing system, save you use the thing that God put in the earth as it begins with. The Bible says the cattle upon 1,000 hills belong to him. The earth is the Lord. Check this out. The earth is the Lord. The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. And they, the earth, first of all, the earth is his. The universe is his. China is his. Russia is his. The British nations are his. America is his. The Pentagon is his. The White House is his. The earth is the Lord. The fullness thereof. That means everything in the earth, the fullness of the earth. And they that dwell there, that means Trump, Obama, myself, it don't matter. They that dwell therein, day, everybody belongs to God. So trust me when I tell you, when he gets ready to release this, ain't no devil in hell going to be able to stop it. And if you try to stop it, well, you know, we stop God. The Bible says, God holds the island as a speck of dust in his hand. As the speck of dust in his hand. If he claps his hand, the earth will have a tsunami. If he stomps his feet, he'll put a hole in the earth. If he blows his breath, the earth will freeze over. Amen. 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 If he sheds a tear, the earth would have another flood. He's that powerful. Trust me. Trust me when I tell you. When it's time, this thing is done. He's a big, big God. Who can stand against him? Who can stand before him? Hallelujah. 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 He's a bad man. Angels all around him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. So I want you to come back. I want you to remember that when you're listening to all these intel guys. Come on, oh no. Oh baby, can't nobody stand against God. When God commands this thing to happen, it's gonna happen. Hallelujah. God stood on nothing and called everything into existence. Let there be light, that there was light. Hallelujah. Let there be a firmament in the midst of the water. You think he can't call an RV for it? Come on, people. You must not know who you serve. He's a big, big God. Bless his name. He's a gracious God. He's a glorious God. The Bible says the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the just. The wealth of the wicked is laid. How you suppose you're going to get it? You think you're just going to wake up in the morning with zeros in your bank account? If you wake up in the morning with zeros in your bank account, please don't spend the money. Please, somebody made a mistake. Don't spend it. You're going to have a jailhouse ministry. Don't spend it. Because that's not the wealth of the wicked. That's a bank error. This, my brothers and sisters, this RV GCR is the wealth of the wicked stored up for the just. The Bible says, he that by usury and unjust gain gathers it for him that will consider the poor. Will you consider the poor with your money? Will you consider the poor with the finances that the Lord has given you? I hope you do. I hope you do. I hope you do. Because you will answer for every dime you spend. Bless the Lord your God with it. For it is he that has given you the ability to get wealth. And I'll dare say it is he that even gave you the mindset of faith. That told you that you believed that you could honor a $25 gem and turn it in to get multiplied millions of dollars. And before you can even spend through the principal, you're going to make millions of dollars in interest. You know there's got to be God. For you to even have the faith, when everybody was calling you dumb, and everybody was calling you stupid, how you going to spend $25 and get millions watching this thing? He said, I'll give you hidden treasures, secret riches. That's what he said. Mm-hmm. That's what he said. This is secret. And this is him. Oh, I feel prayer coming on. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your glory. Thank you for your presence. We bless your name tonight. We don't come to talk about an RV. We come to bless your name. For you are gracious and glorious. You're the God of the ages. You're the God of the universe. You're the God of the earth. Who can stand before your presence? Who can stand before your grace? Thank you for calling us into your presence. Thank you for calling us into your grace. We could not come and save you called us. We cannot come save the blood of Jesus has scored us. Lord God, thank you for the blood of the Lamb. Thank you for the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for his crucified body. Thank you for the 39 stripes across his back that we will be healed, Lord, not only physically, but mentally and emotionally. Thank you, Lord, that we are no longer strangers, but we are sons and daughters of the cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are sons and daughters. We're not slaves. Hallelujah. We are sons and daughters of the kingdom of the living God. We thank you, Lord. If there was no RV, we'd still praise you. If there was no GCR, we'd still give you glory. If we did not have money, come on, we would still lift up the name of Jesus. For the name of Jesus, every knee bow and every tongue confess of things in heaven and things in earth. And things under the earth shall bow their knees in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, confessing that he is Lord of all, to the glory of God the Father. Thank you for power. Thank you for authority. Thank you that we can come into your presence. I don't care about nobody else's presence, Lord, but we care about yours. I thank you that we can step into the presence of the King of the universe. Thank you that we can step into the presence of the King of the world. Hallelujah. For you have all power in your hand. For heaven and earth has been given to the Lord God. Heaven and earth has been given to Jesus Christ. For he is the King of kings, and he is the Lord of lords. He is the great I am. He is wonderful, mighty. He's majestic. He's glorious. He's full of grace. He's full of truth. He's full of power. Thank you, Lord, that you're over every principality. Thank you, Lord, that you are every power. You are every government. You are the government of the earth. You are the government of heaven. Thank you that heaven declares and the earth must do. Whatever we bind on earth is bound in heaven, and whatsoever we loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. And so, Lord God, tonight, I loose over everybody on this call, over every born-again, blood-bought believer, I release joy. I release peace. I release prosperity. And Father, as I have talked before we have prayed, bless each individual person and family that you would sustain them until we exchange, that they would be not so hungry for exchange that they can't say anything else. Bless them now. Bless them tonight. Lord, send prosperity now, as the psalmist David said. Send prosperity now. We need it now. We don't need it next week. We don't need it next month. We don't need it in 2019. We don't need it in 2020. We need it today. January 23rd, 2018. Send prosperity now. In the name of Jesus. Set us in a broad place. 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 Not a narrow place. Set us in a broad place. Set our family in a broad place. Set them down in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus and by the power of the Holy Ghost, I give you praise and I give you glory. I honor your name. I magnify you. You are worthy. You're glorious. You're mighty. You're graceful. You're full of peace. And we bless your name. We glorify you. And we thank you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bless you tonight. 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 Thank you, Lord, that we are like the people that knocked on the door, seeking bread, seeking bread, seeking bread, seeking bread. And I thank you, Lord, that you are opening up the door, giving us all we need according to our faith. And so we thank you, and we give you praise, and we give you glory. We honor you with our life. We don't worship the RV. We don't worship the elders. We don't worship Trump. Nope. We don't worship any guru.
Nope.
We worship nobody but you. We trust nobody but you. We give glory to nobody but you. You alone. You alone. You alone. So we come now in the name of Jesus, stepping into the court and council of heaven, and we release this RV, this GCR, to the nations. We release it to your people. We take the authority of Jesus Christ and command that the blood of Jesus get on the wings of the RV. Get on the wings of the GCR and bring it into us swiftly, mightily, in Jesus' name, unchecked, unhindered in any way. We command it to be done now by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And our testimony is we have exchanged and we are living in the abundance and truth of the Lord God Himself. We have exchanged and we are living in the abundance and truth of the Lord God Himself. We bind every adversary. We command in the name of Jesus that every adversary that will seek to touch this in any demonic way, that their hand will call by shy, their hand will wither up, and that their left hand will not know what their right hand is doing in the name of Jesus. And they will be confused, dizzy, caught by, because they have sought to touch what the Spirit of God is doing. Oh my God, do you hear me? They have sought to touch what it's a dangerous thing to touch what the Spirit of God is doing. Keep your hands off of it. God is trying to free His people. God is trying to free His people. Take your hands off of it. God said, let my people go, that they may worship me and me alone. So said the Spirit of the living God. So saith the Spirit of the living God. So saith the Spirit of the living God. My people have prayed. My people have fasted. And I have heard the cries of my people. And it shall be done. 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 In the name of the Father. In the name of the Son, Yeshua Himself. And in the name of the Holy Ghost. Oh, my God. Yet it can be a little kushtaba. Yet I can be the Ogo Rabana, can be the Christian, the Boko Nabaya. Yet it can be a mother. Yet the Kushtaba, the Kumna, the Gandam of the Kushtaba. Yet it can be a Laman of Kura, for Kushtaba, it can be a Laman. Kondabat can be a Laman. Can be a Laman of Kushtaba. For there is a peace that will fill every house tonight. A peace knowing that the Lord has heard our prayer. I don't care what any guru says. You know that the Lord has heard us and He is coming to deliver us and set us in a broad place. A broad place. A broad place. And when He does, you tell people that no man made you rich but God.
Amen.
God bless you. God keep you. As I pray the Aaronic blessing over you. Let me tell you this too. I feel it in my spirit. Those of you that have been coming on this prayer call, yeah, you're going to be wealthy. We're not concerned about that. You're going to have money. That's a given. But God is doing something supernatural in your lives that money will not be able to buy. Okay? What God is doing for you, you can't write a check for it. Because you just, you came. Everybody wants to jump on intel calls, and most of them are false anyway. You'll realize that one day. Most people jump on intel calls. Most of it is false anyway. But very few people jump on a call that's really getting it done. Isn't that amazing? Very few people jump on a call that's really, really getting it done. We're not doing it. God is doing it. But this is the intel. This is the intel. Because, you know, these cabal members and these people, they switch this, switch that, switch this. Tell one person one thing. Tell another person another thing. Tell the other person a half of the thing. And tell another person a fourth of the half of the fourth that they told the other person. It means nothing. We're going to get to the bottom of it with the wisdom of God. So, Father, I thank you that you bless them. Keep them. Cause your face to shine upon them. Lift up your countenance upon them and be gracious unto them. And give them peace in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We bless your name and we give you glory in Jesus' name. God bless you all. God bless you. God bless you. God keep you in Jesus' name. Amen. Good night.
Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Anybody grateful tonight? Let me hear you. Put your hands
Shout it out, shout it out.
Fighting for us. And he's on our side, amen.